So going into, I guess, college then, I know UCI is like a local, you know, college that's, you know, I'd say very successful. How do we kind of allow people access? Because I know that's a big thing that people talk about is access to higher education, and whether it's a trade school or it's, you know, a UC, whatever it is, cause it's very expensive. You know, are there any statewide initiatives you've planned up or thought about, or you've maybe heard of that you want to speak more towards that allows that kind of movement, whether it's trade school or university, you know, allows mobility and access?
You know, the cost of education, again, you look at, you know, why is it so expensive? When I went to college, I graduated from Long Beach State. I paid $365 a semester.
Yeah, that's nice.
You know, yeah. I mean, it was something that you could actually, you know, work a week and pay that off. So, you know, you could actually afford to have an apartment. You could afford to, you know, go to college and walk away without any debt. Why has the price gone up? Well, you have to look at where's the money going? And it's going to pay for professors. It's going to pensions again. And so there's a point where we just have to stop, you know, in regards to the pensions that we're spending. We have to stop putting this money there. Again, school should be affordable. That very small percentage is actually going to the school. It's going to administration. It's going to pensions.
Yeah. So then how at a statewide level would you push that? Because there's, you know, different ways to do it. And I'm not sure how the UC funding even works. Is like UC is, you know, here, University of California. Is that a statewide initiative, or is that, you know, do they get funding from the state?
They get funding. And I know a couple of years ago they did an audit. And they found a lot of money that was sitting there that wasn't being used. So I think, again, talk about transparency. We have to audit, figure out where the money's going, you know, because they just know each time they just keep raising tuition. But the tuition, again, is going for pensions. Yeah. You know, it's not going to where it's supposed to go. And it's just like we're talking about school bonds. The money isn't going to repairs. Mm-hmm. It's going everywhere but there. So that's all about transparency. And I think auditing and being accountable for what they have to do.
And does that fall under the comptroller? Does that fall under, is there a specific entity? I'm blanking on the name of an entity that we work with in construction. Is there like a specific entity that's in charge of that? I believe that there is.
There is, you know, yeah. So they would actually go and they would do an audit. But again, when they do an audit, it's great to have an auditor come from outside and not actually have the same, a third party auditor instead of having them audit themselves, because we know that doesn't work well.
Yeah. So then is that an issue of policy and that there's no basically checks against that audit?
Right.
Because it's, you know, California audit in California.
Well, and that's what's important. So, you know, trying to get the legislation to go ahead and approve that. I think, again, you have to go across the table. You have to sit there and explain, listen, this is important. Students can't afford to, you know, to go to college anymore. Why? Because of this. Let's make a change. Let's start and see why is it that they can't. And there are good people up in Sacramento with common sense that can actually get the job done.
Yeah.
It's just you have to want to do it.